Hello friends, today we are going to see the effect of shadow and use of shadow in the drawing. Shadow is a very interesting subject. If you want to create any kind of still life, or whether it is portrait or something else, we are going to see what kind of shadows can be created with different lights. Okay. Generally, you must have seen in my drawing or my assignments, I create or render soft shadows like this. Okay, and why do I take soft shadows? Generally, it's to create a pleasing effect. At the same time, it creates a good effect of depth. Okay, it's not like that hard shadows are bad, but different environment create different kind of effects. Now let us see the soft shadows and sharp shadows. But before rendering or studying or considering the soft shadows, we must know about the actual sharp shadows. So let us see here. Right now the light is a soft light. Okay, so I'm going to use a sharp light or create different kind of shadows. Okay, so just I'm keeping one box. If I use a sharp light, the shadows will be like this, okay? The shadows will be darkest. At the same time, as there is no any environmental light, the shadows will be the darkest, okay? See its edges coming very sharp. If I put any sphere here, see the what kind of shadow create here. It's a perfectly sharp, but it's a perfectly ellipse. Okay. If I move my lights towards the ground, towards the base, the shadow gets elongated. Shadow gets longer. See. The shadow gets closer to the ellipse, to closer to the sphere, but it is elliptical. Okay. Here as well, if I put down my light, the shadow become longer. Okay. Now I will show you another example as well. See, this is a simple pot, clay pot. See the shadow. Okay. Shape. It's a sharp. This is another pot. This is another pot. Okay. Awesome. And these kind of shadows or sharp shadows can be used in putting some seriousness into your still life or any scene or any composition. Okay. Let's see the shadows. Generally, you must have seen any suspense movies, the shadows used over there are sharp shadows or dark shadows, okay? And if you want to create a pleasant scene, the shadows will be the softer with the softer light. Now, I am changing my light to a softer source. That is a bigger source, lights coming from the umbrellas. The same kind of same shadows are transformed into softer shadows. See its edges are slightly blurred. Okay. If I put my cube again into here, see the shadow edges, and it looks more interesting, and it brings more the kind of depth in this scene, total oral scene. If I put a sphere, it looks more interesting with the softer edges. Now I am going to show the same kind of effect here as well, the softer edge here. Okay. Here the edge will be sharper. Okay, can show you. I'm putting my camera up. You can see this is a sharper edge here and softer edge here. So in the drawing as well, see the impact of sharp shadow. Okay, this is a drawing with the sharper shadows. Okay, this is a cylinder and this is a cube. Now if I change the shadows, see the softer shadows. Definitely it brings more depth kind of feeling than this one. Okay, you can see, check the difference. This is a softer shadow. It brings more life into drawing. Okay, rather than creating any suspense kind of feeling. So you can use softer shadows to create more interest in or more depth into your drawing or painting. Okay. The softer light, bigger shadows with the softer edge. Okay. So thank you so much for watching this little session on the shadows. Stay tuned for our another video.